get right service at right time at right cost.
पर हम सब जानते हैं जमाना बड़ा तेजी से बदल रहा है. आज के युग में ऐसी इक्विपमेंट को जॉब कर दिया कि वो बीमारी को ढूंढते भी है और बीमारी का इलाज भी करते हैं.
First of all, I don't know what he has called me here because health is a very big topic. So from where to start and where to end, I don't know. But I just want to know, I tell you, we face so many problems of communicable and uncommunicable disease. And I think this is the conclave has been put up, a state of the art infrastructures in the hospitals. I didn't able to get time to organizer what for this conclave has been put up, but what I can understand is that e-health magazine makes the awareness among the health worker, health provider, an interaction like what the one of the lady presented, the research brand promoters and two more things. But I just want to tell the August gathering about the Government of India initiatives which the Government of India is taking in the e-health systems, because e-health system is very important. And we have put a proposal, we have done a pilot project in the 4 districts of the country where we are mapping out the whole country as far as the infrastructure, human resource is concerned, so that a person sitting in one place can know that which location, who is the doctor, what are the infrastructure available in that nursing home, how much the doctor is qualified, how much he is a competent, what are the instrument available in that hospitals. So all these information will be available on the websites within a year and half maximum, because 4 months pilot project we have done in the whole country. And we chosen about the 4 district in the country, like in Bihar we chosen Hazaribagh, in Kerala one district, in Gujarat one district. So this 4 district has been mapped out completely. And I don't remember the website, but if you go on the website, then in the district you will know the which street, who is the doctor sitting, and what is his qualification, what is his name, and what are the infrastructures. Same way you can know about the government setup also. So this is the one of the major project is going on. Now in the, even in the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, now the e-filing has been started. So even a small file, we do the e-signings. So these are things has been taken up. And as you know that now we are fighting with non-communicable disease. Long back we are fighting with the only communicable disease like tuberculosis, leprosy, malaria, filaria, kalajar, and AES. But if you can think of is a non-communicable disease, which is a totally preventable disease, at least 70% you can prevent. When you can't prevent, you can delay. Like you can delay the occurrence of coronary artery disease, you can delay the occurrence of diabetes, you can delay the occurrence of renal disease, you can delay the occurrence of any complication occurring because of a diabetic mellitus. With this concept, now with the AYUSH system, we are working on 6 districts in the country at the moment. We have chosen Bihar in Gaya, UP, we have chosen Lakhimpur Kheri, Rajasthan, we have chosen Bhilwara, Andhra Pradesh, we have chosen Krishnanagar, and Gujarat, we have chosen Sundarnagar. Here, what we have done, that now we are teaching them lifestyles. So we have posted about 30 yoga teachers, and about 30 to 35 40, we have put the Ayush doctors. Ayush means somebody, somewhere like in Lakhimpur Kheri, Unani, Ayurvedic, homeopath. These are the doctors has been posted to teach the people about the lifestyle. And we are also monitoring how from moderate hypertension can be converted to the mild or no hypertension by the change of the lifestyle. Same we are working for the coronary artery disease, how this can be decreased. Because if you see the cost of treatment of the non-communicable disease, whether it is a diabetic, whether it is hypertension, or whether it is coronary artery disease, is a very, very costly to them. And it is not only costly, but it is not curative. Once it has occurred, it is not curative. You can give a palliative things only, whether you do the bypass surgery, or whether you put the stent in the patient, or you control the diabetes. So how to, we are working, the government of India, and as you know, our Prime Minister has also has promoted this yoga in the whole world. So with this concept, with the Ayush system, we have taken this pilot project in the 6th district, and now we have asking the all the health secretary of the state to come up with a proposal, because we want to have a in every district at least one naturopathy hospitals, so that people can come there. They may be taking treatment of diabetic, may be taking oral hypoglycemic agent, but they may, if they do the normal physical activity, normal yoga system, the it may be controlled by the diet only. And if the patient has been on insulin, it can be converted to the oral hypoglycemic agent. So with this concept, already EFC has been passed by the Government of India. Only thing, the state has to come forwards, because the state has to provide the land, and we will be giving the money to the states to open the naturopathy hospitals. And in that also we are asking the corporate, like you must hear the name of the Jindal in Bangalore. So we have asked such people to come forward, and they have agreed to open the naturopathy hospitals with the Government of India. And we are working on that, because now the, our concentration is not only the infrastructures, but also on the preventions. It looks little bit funny things, but I tell you, it is a very, very important part of the health structures today. Because if we invest the money on the preventions, then we have to don't invest the, so much of money in putting the stent and bypass surgery, doing the renal transplant, and so on. Because if you, the cost of the renal transplant and other things is so much very high. Today I will talk little bit about the organ transplant, because 13th August is a organ transplant day. And just want to inform you, the Government of India has formed a NOTO in the Safdarjung Hospital. It's a National Organ Tissue Transplant Organization, which have a five branches. That is called Regional Organ Tissue Transplant Organization. Five branches, one in Chennai, Madras Medical College, one in PGI Chandigarh, other is in KM Hospital, Bombay, one is Kolkata Medical College, and fifth is in Guwahati Medical College. So the reason why is they will be controlling it, and they will be sharing that how much we have patients waiting for the organs, waiting list, and the places has been taken for the organ donations, and all the information on how much country today we are doing the organ transplant. Because at the moment, the organ transplant is limited only to the few states of the country, especially the Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, and Maharashtra. And few are in Delhi. But recently, with these systems, you will be surprised that we got the organ transplant taken from Indore and Ahmedabad and Aurangabad to Delhi, when the heart was brought to Delhi. And recently, in last 3-4 months, 10 heart transplant has been done. Actually, I remember that 4 or 5 has come from Indore itself. So we have to make the awareness among the people, because once the disease occurs, the in organ like kidney, liver, and hearts, which is a life-saving organs. These are the called, without which they cannot survive. So these things can be replaced, and we are promoting now how to do it. But definitely same time, we are also trying to do that, how the prevention can be taken care of. The most other part is definitely is infrastructures of the country. Because one of the question has been put up to me by the policy maker that why the doctors are not staying in the government setup, why they go in the private setups. The problem is the government setup is a lack of infrastructures, lack of proper infrastructure, lack of proper environment, lack of proper facility to the doctors. Suppose you are posting in a district hospital, surgeon, anesthetist, pediatrician, you have to provide some, because he has a 10 years experience. You can't say that you are posted in district hospital. Just now I was talking to Alokji, MD NRHM, that how you can, he was also asking this question, and the same question has come to me from the PMO yesterday only, that how we can hold the doctors in the government setup. Now, I talked to so many doctors that why people want to go to All India Institute of Medical Science? They don't want to go for money, because they want to go that environment. If they want to do endoscopy, endoscopy will be available to them, so they can do the endoscopy. If they want robotic surgery, they can do the robotic surgery, which is not available in other places. So if you create a proper infrastructures any place in the world, and communication, and law and order, for the doctors, for the persons, I think nobody will say that I cannot go. It is not only the money which matters to them. Definitely, I think now you must be heard the NEET, National Interest Examination Test, that will definitely decrease in coming 4 or 5 years the donation completely. It will be completely preventing the donation, because they become, people think that we have spent 1 crore rupees in becoming a doctor, I should earn the money. So that concept will go away with the needs. And most of them require the proper infrastructures, proper knowledge, proper academic environment to work, proper surrounding. Suppose anybody is going to operation. So these are the one of the important part that we are not able to keep the doctors in the public sectors. And we know that 70% of our populations depends upon the private setups. And the out of the expenditure is very, very high. With this concept, I just want to inform the audience that now the Prime Minister has taken a policy decision of the national insurance policy, where the BPL, BPL means not the BPL card, daily workers, daily wager workers, rickshaw pullers, daily worker in the metro, they all will be covered under this policy. And under this policy, we are covering nearly 40 crore population. And every family will be given up to 1,60,000 rupees for treatments for that year, which includes 30,000 for above 60 years of age. So if there is a two parents who are above the 30, they can be given 30-30. And up to 1 lakh to the family, so 1,60,000. And we are trying to enlist the hospitals, and this will be, I think, will be implemented from the 2017. So this is very one of the very important steps which Government of India is going to take, because out of the pocket expenditure, how to decrease it. Not only that, we are trying to give the money to the state government, so that they can purchase the essential medicine. And we don't want that at the district level and level and primary CSC level, the patient has to spend all the money expenditures. So this is the one of the initiative Government of India wants to give the money to the state, and state can, whatever the money they are spending and how much they need, that will be given to them so that they can purchase the drugs. Another initiative recently has been taken by the Government of India, which we have launched about pharmacy, where the drug, like cancer drug, costing about 10,000 rupees for one drug, it will cost only 1,000 rupees in that pharmacist. Same drug, same brand, there is no difference, because we are now taking directly from the manufacturers. So nearly 90% the cost of the drug has come down. And we have opened recently in Delhi, in RML. We are opening, I think, tomorrow in Safdarjung Hospitals, AIIMS. And it is not, it is all drugs for the cancer which cost outside 1 lakhs will cost only 5 to 10,000 rupees maximum to the poor, to the patients who are coming to the treatment. So this is the one of the step, and Government of India wants to open such type of drug pharmacy in the country, nearly 300, especially in all the government medical college and even the important districts. So this is the one of the other step which we are taking. The another step which we are taking now is upgrading the district hospitals. By upgrading the district hospital, we have chosen nearly at the moment in the country 60 districts who are more than 300-bedded hospitals to convert them in medical college. So we are providing the money to the states so that these districts can be converted into the medical college, and a state has to act on that. So now 36 districts has already, we have paid the money, and rest will be coming. And it will be coming up in another 2-3 years. Then fourth is a PMSSY, Prime Minister's Swasth Yojana. Under this category, we have already given the fund nearly 120 crores to each medical college to develop the super specialty. And under these provisions, we have in every medical college who has no development of the super specialties, they don't have to look for the Bombay, Delhi, Madras, Bangalore, like this, so they can get the tertiary care facility available in this setup. So this is the one of the possibility. Then another step, I'm just telling you what we have taken, is a cancer. So we have chosen 20 state cancer hospitals and 50 already existing cancer hospitals. So making the state cancer hospital, we are providing to the state 120 crores rupees, so that they can, a state alone, cancer hospital can be made in the district, in the states. And nearly 45 crore we are giving to already existing cancer hospital who have no money to buy some linear accelerator, brady therapy, other therapy. So they can take the 45 crores. And so far, we have already given 11 to the 120 crore, 11 states. And UP, we have definitely, I want to inform UP that UP, we have chosen three like that, because UP is one of the biggest state in our country. Bihar, we have chosen two. And not last but least, I'm just telling you, one of the initiatives which government has taken is to open AIMS like institution in every states. And so far, we have already launched in the 15 states. So these are the few steps which we are taking. Definitely, the result may not be seen today, but it will be definitely soon seen after 3-4 years. Because if you put any even seed in the your field, you get that at the time only you can get the things from field. So definitely we have put up the things in the proper way, and if things goes all of the way, but we require all the corporations like all of you, the civil society, the state governments, initiatives, positive thought, because we don't face much problem in the south. Whatever the money we give, they utilize. UP, other eastern part of the government are not able to utilize the money properly. It takes time, unspent money. So these things are required. And I given you only few incidents what the government is doing. Much beyond that, we are going ahead. We are thinking at also reforming the medical structures. We want that any MBBS doctor who become the doctor is able to treat a family like a family physician. So we are changing the curriculum of the MBBS doctor also. We are not asking them to read so big book of ENT, I, whatever they require for the normal day-to-day, because I don't want that he should become the ENT surgeon or eye surgeon. What was going on in the MBBS curriculum, that the big book is to taught them. So we are not telling them to read this. Like if you will be surprised to know that in our country, the 7 to 8, 10% people are suffering from mental illness. And it is a great problem in the country. And this is the reason that now we have included the mental health study as a compulsory subject in the medical curriculums. And you must be knowing recently, the mental health policy has been passed by the Government of India about a week back. So these are the few steps the Government of India has taken, and definitely we are in the progressive ways as far as the health is concerned. and will come forwards. I think Pandeji is sitting here, who is doing lots of construction of the AIIMS, even central government hospitals. So I think the e-health magazine of yours, who is branding, now brand the government of India also. Thank you.